We live in a hard-hearted generation where the people's consciences have become seared. It's seared because of pornography. They have become desensitized because of alcohol and drugs. They have forsaken the God of all creation. They have forsaken the fountains of living water. And they have hewn up for themselves cisterns, broken cisterns that hold no water. They have forsaken the fountains of living water. And they hewn up for themselves cisterns, broken cisterns that hold no water. They have hewn up for themselves cisterns of drunkenness, cisterns of drugs, cisterns of perversion. They have forsaken the God of all creation who sent his son, Jesus, to die for their sins. And they have hardened their hearts to the truth. The Bible says that in the last days, that the love in the people's hearts will grow cold. And this is where we at today. People don't care about their soul. They live in rebellion towards God. They do drugs, they watch pornography, they practice homosexuality and fornication, and they think they're okay with God, and they are deceived. And today we are warning you to come to God before it's too late. Turn to the Lord while you hear the preaching of his word out here in the streets. For God is offering mercy. This is the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ. That although you are living a life of rebellion, that God sent his son to die for your sins, that you can find salvation. But you got to choose this day who you're going to serve, because time is running out, sir. The clock is ticking, and soon and very soon, you're not going to be here anymore, and you're going to give an account to your life. The Bible says we will all stand before the judgment seat of God. We will all stand and give an account for our life. And ma'am, you know, the Bible says that most people are going to hell. That's what the Bible says. That many travel the broad way that leads to destruction, but only few find the road that leads to life. That's what the Bible says. You would think that most people are going to be okay with God when they die, but that's not what the Bible says. That most people are going to hell. That most people are on the broad way that leads to destruction. They are on the broad way right into the bar rooms. They are on the broad way right to putting the liquor bottle to their mouth. They are on the broad way. They are living in sexual sin. And they think everything's going to be okay, but it's not, my friends. If you do not repent and come to the Lord and lay hold of God's mercy through the Lord Jesus Christ, you are going to die in your sin and you're going to go to hell. A lot of you are drinking your lives away. Your life is just a cycle of drunkenness. You're broken and you're angry. You're living rebellious. You're living in continual drunkenness. And the Bible says that no drunkard is going to enter into God's kingdom. That means if you're out here and you're living in drunkenness, you're not going to enter into God's kingdom. It's not our way, sir, it's God's way. And God's way is holiness. And the Bible says, without holiness, no one will see the Lord. That means we have to come to God and get real. God is saying, come to him and get real. Stop playing games because time is running out. It's a fearful thing to stand before a holy God. It's going to be a fearful thing to stand before a holy and righteous God. The Bible says that we are to fear God and keep his commandments, sir. Fear God and keep his commandments, because he has the power to cast you into hell. Turn to the Lord and live holy. Be ye holy, God says, for he is holy. God is saying today, ma'am, without holiness, you will not enter into the kingdom of God. Without holiness, ma'am, you're going to go to hell. Think about your life, please. Don't turn the music up on the preacher because he cares for you. You can stick the middle finger, but there's a day coming, and it might come sooner than what you think, ma'am, where you're going to stand before God. The preacher loves your soul and he cares about you. Ma'am, if you don't repent and get right with God and turn away from your sexual perversion, you're going to die and you're going to bust hell wide open. Turn to the Lord. This might be your last chance. Repent and turn to the Lord. Repent and get right with the Lord Jesus Christ. We live in a very arrogant and prideful and hard-hearted generation. They don't want to hear the preachers out here pleading for their souls. They don't want to hear that they got to live righteously and live holy. They want to live in the darkness and they hate the light. We live in a generation that is hell-bent on their way to hell. And my friends, without salvation, you are going to be judged. There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Come to the Lord, sir, while you still hear the preaching of God's word out here. Turn to the Lord and get right with God. For the Lord delights in mercy over judgment. God's delight is not that you go to hell, ma'am. God's delight is that you come to Him and that you find salvation, that you be reconciled to Him. But you have to repent. If not, you're going to die in your sin and you're going to go to hell. Death is coming for you, ma'am. It is appointed once for you to die. And then after that, the judgment. It is appointed once for you to die. And then after that, the judgment. It is appointed once for you to die. And then after that, the judgment. There is a fearful day of judgment, and we will all get our chance to stand before God. And He will definitely remind you of all the chances you had to get right with Him, but you have rejected Him. You have forsaken the fountain of living waters so that you can live for yourself and live for the world. The Bible says, do not love the world or the things of the world. If you love the things of the world, the love of the Father is not in you. All that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, the pride of life, all that is of the world. It is not of the Father. And the world is passing away and the lust of it. But he who does the will of God abides forever. And God's will is that you repent. God's will is that you turn away from your iniquities and get right with God. God's will is that you turn and live holy, sir, and get right with God because time is running out. God's will is that you don't go to hell. This is why God sent His Son Jesus. God sent His Son Jesus so that we can be reconciled to God in right relationship and that we don't go to hell, because there's going to be hell to pay for all those who reject the salvation of God. Repent and turn to the Lord, ma'am, you on this motor scooter. Come to the Lord before it's too late. Turn to Jesus, ma'am. You got a chance. A lot of people died today. They're not here today, but you're still alive. While you still hear the preaching of the Word of God, ma'am, get right with God. We have all sinned, and we are all going to stand before the Lord. And when you die, if you rejected God's salvation, ma'am, you're going to go to hell. God wants you to understand this. But the good news is, He offers you mercy while you're still alive. So, ma'am, please come to the Lord. Come to God. Lay hold of the mercy seat. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent, because judgment day is coming. Repent, because the axe is at the root of the tree. Repent and turn away from that liquor bottle, ma'am. Repent and put down the weed smoking. Repent and turn away from your pornography, sir. Repent and come to God and lay hold of the mercy seat of the Lord Jesus Christ while you still hear the preaching of His word.